Hello, and welcome to KDAB News, the monthly update for professionals working with Qt, C++, and 3D technologies. I'm Robert Brock, and before we start, I just wanted to let you know that you can also follow us on Mastodon. The account is there. So go on, give it a follow. And otherwise, in this edition we have Rust bindings for Qt, an interview with B. Wilson from KDAB, Qt 6.5 released, tip of the month, and announcements. About a year ago, KDAB introduced CXX Qt, safe Rust bindings for Qt. A lot has been added and improved since then, so today I talked to one of the developers, B. Wilson, to get an update. Hi B, thanks for joining me.
Hello.
What has changed in the last release of CXX Qt?
In the last release of CXX Qt, which was our 0.4 version, we refactored the CXX Qt API so that it is now a superset of CXX. Whereas before, we had some specially named items within the bridge describing the language boundary, and CXX Qt handled those in a special way to generate Q objects. Now we've refactored that so you explicitly annotate the parts of the bridge that you want CXX Qt to handle specially and generate Q objects. For that, this allows more seamless integration with whatever CXX code you want to write. So you can write bindings to C++ code you have in your existing C++ application and more easily combine that with Rust code together with writing the Q objects in Rust.
Mm-hmm. That's great.
Additionally, we've overhauled the build system. So now you can build a CXX Qt project either with CMake or you can do it entirely with Cargo. So with CMake, that allows you to integrate into an existing C++ application that uses CMake as its build system. Additionally, what's new here is that CXX Qt can build just a Rust project with Cargo. Currently, you still need to write a little bit of boilerplate C++ code, but that gets compiled by Cargo, and you don't need to also have a separate C++ build system. And we're working to minimize the amount of C++ you need to write and work towards being able to do everything from Rust.
Ah, nice. So that'll save some time and effort. And what new features are coming in the next version of CXX Qt?
So in the next version of CXX Qt, we have several features in the works. We've added support for several of Qt's container types, like QVector and QList and QHash. We are adding support for being able to call methods of a base class when you're writing a subclass with CXX Qt. And this is going to really help with writing your models for Qt's model view frameworks in Rust without needing to write your own boilerplate C++ code.
It's quite the list of features to look forward to then. Great. Well, thank you for your time, B.
Thank you.
If you want to learn more about it or try it out, you'll find more information below in the description. Qt 6.5 adds three new modules, Qt gRPC, Qt Location, and Qt Quick Effect Maker. In addition to these, there are new features and improvements within the existing modules. Qt Quick Effects Maker helps you to create high-performance shader effects for Qt Quick. Qt Location is a module for rendering 2D maps into a Qt Quick application. It is still in technical preview, so the API and ABI ability is not guaranteed. And finally, Qt gRPC, which is based on gRPC, a cross-platform, open-source, high-performance remote procedure call framework that was initially created by Google. Qt gRPC is a supermodule that also provides Qt ProtoBuf. Protocol buffers are used to serialize structured data. The module is useful in developing programs to communicate with each other over a network or for storing data. Qt ProtoBuf enables you to generate, serialize, and deserialize Qt-based classes from ProtoBuf.proto specifications. Qt gRPC enables communication with gRPC services using classes generated based on service descriptions from Proto specifications. Also, this module is still in technical preview. Check out the complete list of features added to existing modules. The release target for the final version is the end of March. In this section, we usually recommend a useful tool or library. This time, we recommend a blog post by our colleague Giuseppe D'Angelo, in which he is looking closer at the following topic. In C++, you may sometimes need to allocate uninitialized storage, storage that you plan to fill later. As such, it is wasteful to pay for its immediate initialization. C++20 and C++23 introduced some more structured facilities for this purpose. Also, Qt has had some of these facilities for quite some time, in classes like QString, QByteArray, and last but not least, QVarLengthArray. What? What is QVarLengthArray? Well, it is a container class with interesting semantics, not found in any other container from the standard library. Like an array, it stores elements contiguously in memory. Like a vector, it has dynamic size, but unlike a vector, it does not necessarily store them in heap-allocated memory. Do you want to learn more about it? Well, Giuseppe D'Angelo sheds light on this topic in his latest blog post, which analyzes the situation and the different approaches in the C++ and Qt APIs. Have a look at the link below to learn more. Embedded World 2023 in Nuremberg, Germany is coming closer. You'll find the KDAB booth in Hall 4, booth number 302. Come and check out our new demos and talk to our experts. To get your free ticket, simply use the code EW23WEB on the Embedded World website. A few event dates have recently been announced for 2023. First, KDE Academy 2023 will happen in Thessaloniki, Greece, from the 15th to the 21st of July. So, mark your calendar. Academy will be a hybrid event combining on-site and remote sessions, and will include talks, workshops, bird of a feather meetups, training, and coding sessions. The call for papers will open soon, and registrations shortly thereafter. Further, Meeting C++ has announced that it will take place as a hybrid event again in Berlin and online, from the 12th to the 14th of November. Stay tuned for the call for papers and further details. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, and feel free to share any feedback or questions below the video. I'll see you next time.